peux vous interpréter une petite composition. Ça s'appelle La Chanson. La chanson du premier arrêt. La chanson du poisson d'arrêt. La chanson du premier arrêt. Poisson d'arrêt.
Bonjour, ceci est un poisson d'avril. Un poisson d'avril est une plaisanterie, voire un canular, que l'on fait le 1er avril à ses connaissances ou à ses amis. Il est aussi de coutume de faire des canulars dans les médias, aussi bien presse écrite, radio, télévision que sur Internet. Pour les enfants, il consiste à accrocher un poisson de papier dans le dos de personnes dont on veut se gausser. Poisson d'avril est aussi l'exclamation que l'on pousse une fois qu'une des plaisanteries est découverte. Cette tradition trouverait son origine en France, en 1564. La légende veut que jusqu'alors, l'année aurait commencé au 1er avril. En fait, le 25 mars correspondait selon le calendrier julien au jour de l'an, à la fête de l'Annonciation à Marie avec la tradition de s'échanger des cadeaux, mais le roi de France Charles IX décida, par l'édit de Roussillon, que l'année débuterait désormais le 1er janvier, marque du rallongement des journées, au lieu de fin mars, arrivée du printemps. Mais en fait, l'année civile n'a jamais débuté un 1er avril. Si l'origine exacte de l'utilisation des poissons reste obscure, peut-être l'ai-je-tu chrétien, il semble que beaucoup de personnes eurent des difficultés à s'adapter au nouveau calendrier. D'autres n'étaient pas au courant du changement et continuèrent à célébrer le 1er avril selon l'ancienne tradition. Pour se moquer d'elle, certains profitèrent de l'occasion pour leur remettre de faux cadeaux et leur jouer des tours. Les cadeaux que l'on s'offrait en avril étaient le plus souvent alimentaires. Cette date étant à la fin du carême, période de jeûne durant laquelle la consommation de viande est interdite chez les chrétiens, le poisson était le présent le plus fréquent. Lorsque les blagues se développèrent, l'un des pièges les plus courants était l'offrande de faux poissons. Ainsi naquit le fameux poisson d'avril, le jour des fous, le jour de ceux qui n'acceptent pas la réalité ou la voient autrement. Une autre origine vient du fait que le 1er avril était le jour où la pêche devenait interdite, afin de respecter la période de reproduction. Pour faire un cadeau aux pêcheurs, et pour se moquer un peu d'eux, on leur offrait un hareng. C'est alors qu'une habitude populaire s'installa, on accrochait subrepticement un vrai poisson dans le dos des gens. Comme les habits étaient plus larges, les victimes ne s'en apercevaient pas tout de suite, de sorte que le poisson devenait de plus en plus gluant et puant. Ainsi naquit le goût de faire ce jour-là des petits cadeaux pour rire, des plaisanteries ou des mystifications. Plusieurs usages semblent s'être en fait mélangés avec celui du carnaval. Marquer la sortie du signe zodiacal des poissons, dernier signe de l'hiver. Prolonger la période du carême, où il n'est permis de manger que du poisson. Confondre le benêt en lui offrant un poisson à une époque de l'année, celle du frais, où la pêche était interdite. En France, Au début du XX siècle, on s'envoyait de jolies cartes postales toutes ornées d'un poisson d'avril richement décoré. Le musée du château de Dieppe conserve une très importante collection de cartes postales sur ce thème. Cette coutume de faire des plaisanteries s'est répandue dans de nombreux pays, bien que le poisson ne se soit pas toujours exporté en même temps. Les Américains et les Britanniques ont conservé leur April Fool's Day. Certains Écossais parlent aussi de Gaulle ou de Cucol. Les Allemands ont leur April Shears. Cette coutume existe aussi au Danemark, aux Pays-Bas, en Belgique, au Canada, en Italie, en Pologne, au Portugal, aux États-Unis, en Suisse, en Suède, en Finlande, ou même au Japon. En Russie, il s'appelle le jour des fous, Den Durakov. En Roumanie, il s'agit de la tromperie ou du pari du 1er avril, Cléal de 1 aprili. Au Portugal, il s'appelle jour des mensonges, Dia das Mentira.
April Fool's Day, alternatively April Fool's Day, sometimes All Fool's Day, is celebrated on April 1st every year. April 1st is not a national holiday, but is widely recognized and celebrated in various countries as a day when people play practical jokes and hoaxes on each other called April Fools. 1. In Italy, France and Belgium, children and adults traditionally tack paper fishes on each other's back as a trick and shout April Fish, in their local languages, Passe di April, Poisson di Avril and Aprilvis in Italian, French and Flemish, respectively. Such fish feature prominently on many late 19th to early 20th century French April Fool's Day postcards. The earliest recorded association between April 1st and foolishness is an ambiguous reference in Chaucer's Canterbury Tales, 1392. Many writers suggest that the restoration of January 1st by Pope Gregory XIII as New Year's Day of the Gregorian calendar in the 16th century was responsible for the creation of the holiday, sometimes questioned for earlier references. In 1508, French poet Éloi de Merville referred to a Poisson d'Avril, April Fool, literally April Fish, a possible reference to the holiday. 9. In 1539, Flemish poet Edward de Deen wrote of a nobleman who sent his servants on foolish errands on April 1st. In 1686, John Aubrey referred to the holiday as follows: Holy Day, the first British reference, on April 1st, 1698. Several people were tricked into going to the Tower of London to see the lions washed. In the Middle Ages, up until the late 18th century, New Year's Day was celebrated on March 25th, Feast of the Annunciation, in most European towns. In some areas of France, New Year's was a week-long holiday ending on April 1st. Many writers suggest that April Fools originated because those who celebrated on January 1st made fun of those who celebrated on other dates. The use of January 1st as New Year's Day was common in France by the mid-16th century, and this date was adopted officially in 1564 by the Edict of Roussillon. In the UK, an April Fool joke is revealed by shouting April Fool at the recipient, who becomes the April Fool. A study in the 1950s, by folklorists Iona and Peter Obi, found that in the UK, and in countries whose traditions derive from the UK, the joking ceased at midday. A person playing a joke after midday is the April Fool themselves, but this practice appears to have lapsed in more recent years. In Scotland, April Fool's Day is traditionally called Hunt the Gowk Day, Gowk is Scots for a cuckoo or a foolish person. Although this name has fallen into disuse, the traditional prank is to ask someone to deliver a sealed message requesting help of some sort. In fact, the message reads "Dinna laugh, dinna smile, hunt the gowk another mile." The recipient, upon reading it, will explain he can only help if he first contacts another person, and sends the victim to this person with an identical message, with the same result. In Iran, jokes are played on the 13th day of the Persian New Year, Noruz, which falls on April 1st or April 2nd. This day, celebrated as far back as 536 BC, is called Sizdabidar and is the oldest prank tradition in the world still alive today. This fact has led many to believe that April Fool's Day has its origins in this tradition. The April 1st tradition in France, Romandy and French-speaking Canada includes Poisson d'Avril, literally April's fish, attempting to attach a paper fish to the victim's back without being noticed. This is also widespread in other nations, such as Italy, where the term Pesce d'April, literally April's fish, is also used to refer to any jokes done during the day. This custom also exists in certain areas of Belgium, including the province of Antwerp. The Flemish tradition is for children to lock out their parents or teachers, only letting them in if they promise to bring treats the same evening or the next day. 15. In Poland, Prima Aprilis, April 1st in Latin, is a day full of jokes. Various hoaxes are prepared by people, media, which sometimes cooperate to make the information more credible, and even public institutions. Serious activities are usually avoided. This conviction is so strong that the anti-Turkish alliance with Leopold I signed on April 1, 1683, was backdated to March 31. In 1957, the BBC pulled a prank, known as the Swiss Spaghetti Harvest Prank, where they broadcast a fake video of Swiss farmers picking freshly grown spaghetti. The BBC were later flooded with requests to purchase a spaghetti plant, forcing them to declare the video as a prank on the news the next day. In Denmark, May 1st is known as Majkat, meaning May Cat, and is also a joking day. May 1st is also celebrated in Sweden as an alternative joking day. When someone has been fooled in Sweden, to disclose that it was a joke, the fooler says the rhyme April, April, den dumasil, jag kan lura dig var jagvil, April, April, you stupid herring, I can fool you to wherever I want, for April 1st jokes, or majmajmon, jag kan lura dig till skåne, may moon, I can fool you into Scania, for May 1st jokes. Both Danes and Swedes also celebrate April Fool's Day, April's Nur in Danish. Pranks on May 1st are much less frequent. Most Swedish and Danish news media outlets will publish exactly one false story on April 1st. For newspapers, this will typically be a first-page article but not the top headline. December 28th is the equivalent day in Spain and Ibero-America, which is also the Christian day of celebration of the Day of the Holy Innocents. The Christian celebration is a holiday in its own right, a religious one, but the tradition of pranks is not, though the latter is observed yearly. After somebody plays a joke or a prank on somebody else, the joker usually cries out, in some regions of Ibero-America, Inocente palomitic ted egist anganer, you innocent little dove that let yourself be fooled. In Mexico, the phrase is Inocente para siempre, which means innocent forever. In Argentina, the prankster says que la inocencia te valga, which roughly translates as a piece of advice on not to be as gullible as the pranked. In Spain, it is common to say just inocente, which in Spanish can mean innocent, but also gullible. Nevertheless, on the Spanish island of Menorca, Dia de Enganar, Fooling Day, is celebrated on April 1st because Menorca was a British possession during part of the 18th century.